So first, I want to talk about some shape. We haven't really done like a whole lecture just on shapes in a while, if ever. But I'm going to show you a shape. The first shape I'm actually going to show you is just this. I just focus on the middle of the board, forget everything around the sides for right now. But take a look at these two stones. How do you guys feel about these two stones? Is this good shape, bad shape? What do you think?
They can bind by itself. They can connect pretty easily.
Not only can they connect pretty easily, can white ever disconnect them?
Not without like a lot of forcing moves.
Not without a code threat, really.
If white plays there.
Yeah.
Alright. F4 plays here. Alright, of course, you play there. Hey, you connected. Right, so this, for most purposes, is just as good as this. Right, these two stones are connected. These two stones are connected. How about this?
They're not 100% connected like that in the middle of the
game. Actually, they're not connected at all, right? Here.
Fix one.
Ta-da! These two stones disconnected, not connected. Right, or sorry, these two stones, right? Or the original two, not connected. So this, there's actually a connection problem here. Now what's the nice thing about black shape here?
It also cuts white.
Yeah, white has to give up a lot of good shape points. And if we look at this, we just count the liberties. First of all, whose move is it?
Black's.
Black's move. How many liberties does this white stone have?
Two.
How many liberties does this black stone have?
Two.
So those cancel out, that's even. How about this black group?
Five.
Five. How about this white group?
Three.
Three. So we have a two liberty advantage plus this black's move. So that's gonna go very, very well for black, okay? So this is why you see a lot of one space jumps, right? It's a little more greedy, right? Usually this is efficient, right? This is really efficient, or in terms of connection, right? White can't disconnect it. It's also efficient in terms of connection, but in terms of territory, these might be kind of slow. All right, so that's when we play something like this. Now, are these two stones connected? No. But if white tries to start a fight here, it's gonna go very poorly for white. I know we've talked about that before. How about here?
Not in the middle of the board, at least, or definitely not in the middle of the board.
Yeah, this is a very tenuous connection at best, right? There's a relationship, it still works, okay, but very tenuous. If white splits you up, let's see what happens. Where do you play?
Hane.
White actually has a couple options here, but let's just play this one. And then? Connect?
Sure.
White cuts. All right, so now let's compare. How many liberties does this black stone have?
Two.
How many liberties does this white stone have?
Two.
Two. You guys are really festive. How about this black white group?
Four.
Four.
Four. How about this black group?
Well,
six.
Not really. If white just plays one of your diagonal mei and you play the other.
Right,
one.
These are connected. You don't necessarily get both of these as liberties. You might get one.
Yeah.
Maybe.
So you'd have five there.
If white plays this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but you also short white a liberty.
Yeah. Also white played another disconnected stone, so.
Yeah. So let's say 5.5. Okay, so now black has 5.5 liberties, white has 4 liberties. Remember our one space jump? How white only had 3 liberties?
Yeah.
Never seen 4 and 3 is actually a really big difference. So in this case, white can actually fight a lot easier. And not only that, see this stone over here? Before we had a black stone jutting out, sort of not quite taking away a liberty, but starting to curtail it. The stone didn't have a whole lot of places to run to. Over here, now it does. So white's actually a lot stronger here. It's a lot harder for black to fight. So in terms of there being a connection, right? We say this shape is not one you see that whole often, right? It's a lot easier for white to break it up. Well, so you don't see this a whole lot. How about this one? It looks worse, but it's actually, this one you'll see more played more often than this one. So why do you think that would be? Why do you think this is more common than this?
Play it out.
Oh, because you don't
after the Hane, you don't need to make that extension to connect.
So let's say white tries to break this up somehow, here or here, depending. Let's try that one first. So if white just plays this way, let's do that.
It's even better.
That's actually went really well for black, right? Because white only has three liberties now, right? In the last variation we had four. So we can't, that way's not so good. How about if we do this way, attach? What do you play?
Hane.
And we have a couple options here, but how about we play that one? Want to be connected?
Yeah.
White splits. Oh.
If you connect white,
the bottom one.
Yeah. If you play the play that.
Yeah.
This
how
is just in the middle of the board. White can't even do that because it's a ladder.
Yeah. This is pretty easy. Black has a ton of liberties. White. This white stone's even in a ladder right now. Right. So you can actually see that shape in some ways is more durable. Now white can do more interesting things like cross cut immediately. But if we try to break through that shape, just like the other way, it's actually easier for black to defend against it. Which is kind of weird. And it also has the benefit of it actually does cover more territory. Right? This, you know, it's only one area of the board. We're actually starting to spread our wings a little bit. So this is actually more common. Now, it doesn't always work in every situation. You have to read it out. But just know as far as shapes are concerned, we see this one more frequently than this one. Right? Especially around the edges of the board. We also have this one. We can look at that one. But kind of similar idea. Very hard for white to break through it cleanly and get into a good fight. I mean, how would white have to break this? Have to do something like this, right? But as soon as black plays here, how about that white stone? Can white cut? Well, it depends. Yeah. In this case, there's a ladder, right? So, you know, there's varying degrees of danger with all these shapes, right? Basically, the further you spread out, the weaker your shape is going to be, the more easily your stones can get cut off. Okay, so keep that in mind. We're gonna come back to this. I'll first go back all the way back to this original example. Remember our two stones like this? And we talked about white plays here, you're connected, right? That's efficient. White plays here, you're connected, that's efficient. These two stones are forever connected, right? So therefore, you should play at your first chance right here.
No?
No.
Definitely not, Matt. Very good. Why not?
Empty triangle.
Yeah, this is called the dreaded empty triangle. So you guys have been told, I'm sure, countless numbers of times, yes, that empty triangles are bad. You've been told this?
Yes.
So why are empty triangles bad?
It's got fewer liberties than if you had three in a row, and it also makes kind of a weird shape that's hard to make boxes with because it's not a wall.
Good. So, all right, so a couple things. Number one, Tom says it has fewer liberties. Let's verify this. How many liberties does this have?
Seven.
How many liberties does that have? Eight, so it's much better if you put one stone in a row, right? Forget this whole bendy business. Just go straight. Just build walls. Just like, you know, 35 Q players just across the board, right? Okay? Second reason why this is bad. Well, what did we just discuss?
They're already connected.
Already connected. Once you realize these two stones are already connected, how do you feel about putting a stone here?
It's like a wasted move.
It's like a wasted move. That's exactly what it is. And in Go, basically, you know, the whole game is about not wasting moves, right? If you spend a move doing something that you don't really need to do yet, that's going to put you in a losing position. So if you take time during the game to take this shape and go there, we're all going to laugh at you. Yeah.
Well, the shape can still come up if white keeps, for example.
Oh, yeah. There's always exceptions. That's what's why Go is...
It's still a bad shape.
Yeah.
Even though it doesn't waste... Even if you're not wasting time.
Definitely. I'm going to... I'll give you... Here's a classic example. If I can recall it here. Take this one off for a moment. If we come here... And put white here. Right? And white says, aha, I'm going to attack you, I'm going to surround you. Well, if you have any sort of support, you actually need to play this in order to cut white. Right, so sometimes, you know, look, like, black stones are connected, right? So in this case, you actually want to play that. You want to not make the empty triangle. It's better in this case. But if you had more support or had another stone in here somewhere, right? You can't just play this. You have to make an empty triangle and cut away. So there are definitely, you know, areas where you have to make this shape, right, in order to do something that's important. But it's really inefficient, right? You're kind of sad. You're a little bit sad when you have to play this, is my point.
And even in that situation, it's not really about making that shape, it's more about making that move.
It's right. The move is important for another reason, right? We're not making it just for the shape, we're making it for, you know, another reason that will help our game.
What was this?
We're not using it. How about that? Good. There was a fairly recent video posted by Ketelin Tarnu. Anyone know that name? Five non professional from. Where is it?
Romania?
Oh, Romania. Yeah, Romania. That's good. Romania, yes. Anyone see this video? We talked about shape. And he starts with a couple different examples, but I'm gonna try to recapitulate some of my favorite parts of the video. He said, this is according, I'm giving him full credit here. This isn't my own idea, but I thought it was kind of neat. Your stone, this is like a family. This one stone, this is like a little family. And it's got this whole giant landscape. Let's call it like Mother Russia. To go and farm and feed its children. Okay, so look, you have this one family, and it's got a farm over here, it's got a farm over here, it's got a farm over here, it's got a farm over here. So the family's happy, right? Enough food, feed all four members of the family. It's great. Well, how about if we do this? It's okay, you know, it's you know, maybe you'd want to have more space for each farm. It might be better if there's no problems, right? It'd be better to play somewhere further away, right? So I could have, you know, this family farm here and this family farm here, and everybody has enough land to farm. Let's say we do play over here, right? Now these two families are side by side. We had one family got four farms. How many farms do these two families get?
Six.
Six. So that's still pretty good. Three farms per family, but not as good. Right, a little bit, these call this a little bit slow, a little bit inefficient, right? And this is why when we play Go, we try to spread out our stones across the board, right? You can see this efficiency just from trying to feed these families, right? Getting enough farmland for yourself. And if we apply our third move of the game right here, you know, everybody's still kind of happy, but they're having to share a lot more farm space. Yes? All right, new scenario. Let's say we have two families like this. How many farms do these two families have?
Six again.
It's the exact same as this. Exact same number of farms. Right? Two families, six farms. How about if we do it this way?
Seven
farms, right? Whereas over here, we could have eight farms, right? So we saw this before. All right, now this is where my interpretation of Catalan's and mine differ a little bit. Because he tries to say, well, we don't need to put a stone over here until someone else goes here and takes one away our farms. In my interpretation, I'm going to call this a pack of wild animals. Okay? So it's the pack of wild animals. It's coming to eat your farm, eat your family, eat your children. Okay? You have to watch out for this. And that pack of wild animals comes up right up here. Let's say you only have one family. Now, one family against a pack of wild animals, we don't know who's going to win. Might be the family, might be the animals. If the family wins, though, they get extra food. It's like meat. It's like really, it's really savory. Really fills your belly. Okay, so we have a second family. They move in to help eat the pack of wild animals. Now it looks like this pack of wild animals, right? They're gonna get eaten. And sure enough, right? If the wild animals stay put, we have four families here. How many farms?
Nine.
Plus meat. So this is actually good shape. We have four families eat essentially 10 farms. That's okay, right? It's not as good as, you know, one family for four farms, but that's still really good, right, overall, right? So four families eat 10 farms. Really nice. Let's say we have that. Four families.
Eight.
Yeah, eight farms. Not as good. And not only that, it's actually a lot harder to fight off these animals. Right? If these animals start coming, you know, your family can't go in this direction anymore, right? As soon as those animals start growing, it gets more and more challenging. So let's say those two families start out like this again. Here comes a pack of wild animals. If we play there, you know, this, yeah, we have three families, you know, and they're only eating so many farms, but they're very strong against the animals, right? The animals can't come and eat their children, right? All the children are saved. So as these groups go on, you're going to find in your own Go playing, right, when these packs of wild animals come in, i.e. the white player, right, you're going to want to find the ways that band your families together in the most efficient way, right, because that'll make them strong to fight off the wild animals. And so if you have stones like this, we don't know, right? But if you have stones like this, that's pretty easy to fight off wild animals. Very hard for wild animals to come in between two families, right? Also, we bring in a third family and they start attacking it, then it's dinner time. Okay. Anyway, this is kind of a metaphor way out of context. Maybe you should go watch the original Catalan Tarnu video of where he takes it. But it's another interesting way, I think, to think of how to play Go, right? Thinking about the board as this giant farmland, you're just trying to farm it, right? Trying to make sure that your stones have liberties. And essentially, that's what good shape is about, right? When you want to make a good shape, it's about making sure that your stones have liberties, and specifically eyes as well, right? But especially liberties, and making sure your opponent doesn't. Right? Anytime you can find a move that takes away eyes or liberties from your opponents, and give yourselves eyes or liberties for you, that's a really good thing. Cool? All right, let's talk about some other bad shapes. I believe the Japanese call this dango. If you have a clump of stones, it can be any kind of clump of stones, but if your stones ever look like this, have you guys ever had this happen? Your stones, you look at the board and you have like this thing, dumpling shape. This is bad, you've done something wrong. How is this farm family doing?
Starvation.
Yeah, starvation, right? Might as well, I mean, this family would actually be better off dead, right? It would actually help you out tremendously if they just all died. But this family's doing nothing for you. They're just starving in the middle of your colony, right? No farmland there. Whenever possible, right, the same sort of thing applies. You know, we want to avoid this type of shape. All right, so there are a couple common shapes that are good. We've already seen a couple. Remember this one? Who knows the name of this? Mm-hmm. Panuki. This is generally considered a good shape. Lots of farmland. This is one that some of you might know. Have you seen this shape? This is called the mouth shape. This is also considered good shape. And often, you don't just want to play this on the board outright. You know, we want these shapes to derive naturally from our play. We don't want them to just, like, white takes a corner, you play here. 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 Like, that's not efficient, right? White's farming all over the place, and you're farming just this one patch of land really, really well. Not good enough. But this is called the mouth shape. And again, usually, you know, white will have this cut, you know, something like this is a, you know, fairly kind of common thing around it. But why is this shape good for black?
White can't cut.
Yeah, all the stones are connected, right? White has no way, unless white has a couple moves in here for free, that white can disconnect all the stones. Okay, so our stones are strong. It's not a dumpling. We can make an eye whenever we need to. We still have quite a few liberties. You know, that's good. So we're going to look for that mouth shape. How about this shape?
Bamboo joint.
Bamboo joint. What is good about this shape?
White can't disconnect it.
White can't disconnect it. You guys remember this shape? One space jump. What was the problem? If white really, really wanted to, now he'd be at a disadvantage, but if he really, really wanted to, you can cut this in half. How about now?
Not possible.
Not happening. So this is also considered to be a very strong shape. What's the problem with this shape?
Doesn't make eyes.
Very hard to make eyes. Like, all the stones are connected, and it covers a fairly, you know, it's looking in two directions. It's covering a pretty good amount of size of land. But, man, we don't necessarily have eyes. So this is the downside to the bamboo shape. So sometimes bamboo shapes are really good. You know, if you just need a solid connection, as solid as can be, really, really good. If they're need eye shape though, you probably need to look something more like the mouth shape when you start making something more like this. All right, one more shape. And this is a shape that Q players play all the time and Dom players don't. Let's see if I can do this. So let's just put that like that. All right, so what is black shape called here?
Got a trumpet connection.
A trumpet connection?
Yeah, that's what I've heard. I mean, if you take off the extension stones, the double tiger's
okay,
mouth
that,
thing.
There you go. Oh, okay, yeah, yeah. These tiger's mouth, right? You seen this before? This is a shape. How many of you play this in your games a lot? You see this all the time. Yeah, I mean, I do too, quite frankly. But
not on purpose.
Not on purpose. Just happens. Oh, it almost never happens. But you know, often you'll be making a wall here, and you go, "Oh, I should fix." So where do you fix? You're right there, right? Because now white can't do anything to this connection, right? If white plays there and tries to break it up, you just go, yum, panuki, hey, everyone's happy, farmland, meat, we eat tonight. Right, same thing here, white can't do that. Kill, white can't break this up. What's the problem with this shape?
Double peeps.
Yeah, there's, you know, white can start threatening to break it up. And the reason why this is often bad, I mean, sometimes it's good shape. If white can't do these types of moves, it's good shape. But if we're like this, and white can peep here, and you go, actually white would probably peep over here first, just to get the order right. And then white will peep over here and say, hey, what about this one? And you go, well, I better fix. And then white comes around like this, how is black shape now?
Leaves something to be desired.
Okay. Well, how many families are living on this plot of farmland?
Seven.
And how many farms does the seven family town have to share?
Five.
Not so good, huh? Five farms for seven families? This is how family feuds get started, right? This is a problem. So usually, and we'll see some situations in some of these problems, we have to find a better move. Is this here? No, there. We have to find a better move to connect all our stones. And in this case, we're probably looking at that one, right? And now even if white peeps, white doesn't get anything else, right? It's the last free thing that white got. Anything else white has to earn. And especially in this case, if white doesn't play over here, it looks like we can actually start to make a panuki over here and eat some more meat, and we can actually get some eye shape out of this.
It could be cut, though.
It can be cut. This is a very, very astute observation. Before, we could not be cut. But our shape was could be very questionable, right? But in this case, we could be cut. So we have to, if we play this move, right, connect here, we have to read out what happens when white cuts.
White also needs the ladder there.
Number one, white needs a ladder, right? If white doesn't
white
need a ladder.
White has the ladder. Well.
I mean, pretend this isn't there.
Okay.
These are questions we have to ask ourselves rhetorically, right? If we're going to make a strong connection like this, we have to make sure that, you know, either A, we can't be cut, or B, maybe if white cuts, black does a net, and maybe it's bad for white anyway. Maybe we can give up these two stones and surround white over here. Maybe there's something else we can get. There's a lot of possibilities for how this could go. Okay? This is where some reading and fighting skills will be really useful. But just know that this shape is to be avoided in this case. Right? We're going to get pummeled for a while here as black. We're going to get into that dango shape, right? That dumpling shape.
Because
no
of the weak stone on that.
Because of these defects, right? Often when we fix shape, we want to leave as few defects as possible, maximize our liberties, take away liberties from our own point. Those are sort of just general key concepts. Okay, you guys feeling okay about shape? You guys want to do some shape problems? All right, so I got two boards here. I got two boards full of shape problems. And on each of these problems, they're sort of quadrant off, and I tried to arrange them in such a way that they'd make sense, like as if there was a real game going on. I'm not actually sure if the correct number of stones is on the board or not, but if not, pretend it's handicapped or something. All the problems are black to play. So, I saw Tom and Matt looking at this one earlier. We can describe what's going on over here. What's black's problem?
Being split.
Yeah, being split, right? Danger, danger. Wouldn't it be nice if we could gain a whole bunch of liberties really quickly? Because right now, this stone has two. These two stones only have three. And white looks pretty strong over here, right? Looks like we can run out or go this way. White's very strong over here. This one cutting stone is a little bit weak, but we can't capture it in a ladder or anything, right? It just sort of runs to safety. So how do we make shape out here? How do we get our stones to be stronger? Give you guys a minute to think of some ideas.
So are we supposed to avoid losing any stones?
Nope. The goal is to make your stones as strong as possible and your opponent's as weak as possible. Right? It's about making shape.
Okay.
Every saving every last man, that very American and heroic movie, you know, Hollywood concept, does not exist in Go. Right? Go is Chinese game, you know, because we have a billion people, throw 50 at it, we'll fix the problem. Right? That's really bad. No, but it's a very subtle game, right? We're willing to give you a little here, little here, little here if we get the bigger picture. Right? That Hollywood icon of save every last man. That doesn't work in Go. If you play like Go like that, you're not going to win. So we may have to give up some stones. You have an idea, David?
I'm thinking we'd probably do best to give up the top two.
Give up the top two? All right, let's try it.
So let's start with Atari and Loom.
Atari here. Art Sense. And then?
Extend right from the... Yeah.
So you don't want a white to Atari you, take away your shape, right? That would force you into bad shape. All right.
So white can still...
White plays here. David is very annoyed at this move. I like how he saw that, you know, there was weakness here, right? Trying to make sure you have enough liberties, don't let give white free stuff. That's a good idea. But our whole premise might be a little bit wrong. What's going to happen here?
One eye.
Black will get one eye, and then where's black going to have to go?
Out.
Out. And what's the problem with that?
He can't.
Running is bad.
Well, in this case, running is going to be very bad. Right? White's going to get very strong here. White's going to be able to take all these as definite points. White's not only going to come out and be strong here, these are going to be really dead. They're only kind of dead right now, they're going to be really dead. And white will actually essentially control all this entire part of the board if we have to run out and get white strong over here. So I'm going to take this move back. We've got to find a better way to make use of our stones. And again, it's not save every last man.
15-6.
Oh, gosh.
If we were going to go down 15, to this side, Atari on the white stone.
Atari, this way.
No, other way.
This is what David did.
Yeah.
Yeah. Same thing?
Not that I said this would be the best way to go, but my thinking here is that if you do that, you at least got a chance of running white a little bit and you can get out.
Yeah, but if we won white, white's going to get really strong.
Yeah, I know.
And we're going to give white good shape while we're behind.
I'm saying that if we're going to play on the side, this is where I think would be the best chance of getting out and not getting killed.
I disagree.
Okay. You're free. Monitor it then.
Tom, what's your idea?
Mine was loose ladder.
This move is awesome. This is the move you need to find. What are we almost making here?
Almost an end.
It's almost a mouth shape, isn't it? I mean, this is... You just pretend that's there, right?
No.
That's the... We just saw that was an awesome shape. Now, it's not quite there, but it's so close. It's still going to be good for us. Sometimes, all you do is get your shape kind of close, and get something good. All right, so what do you think white's going to do here? Is white just going to let white get eaten? White just says, no, I give up. Tanuki.
Sorry?
Yeah, white has to get out, right? So maybe this?
Yeah.
All right, now what do we do?
White doesn't want you to make a mouth.
Well.
What do you think, Eric?
Well, you could give up that stone.
We could give it up.
Then we're left running again.
And we're left running again.
Extend it.
Extend which one?
The tied stone.
So the stone we're going to give up, we're going to give white more meat?
Yeah.
Yes, we are!
We are? I wasn't going to give it up.
Yeah, of course we're going to give this up.
Oh.
Can white do this?
No.
No, black is Atari's and black's fine. So white has to play here. And can black do this now?
No.
White just went out, needs us, right? We don't like that. But we can play here. New question. Can white do this to split us and make us cry?
No, no.
No.
No, it just ends up as a...
Atari, extend. Atari, extend. Atari, I resign.
Smash.
Smash, yeah. Bad stuff. So where does white have to play if white doesn't want to die?
Extend that.
Extend. Gain more liberties, right? Start killing this. Where does black play?
Second line.
Second line, very good. There. White still has the same problem, right? Not enough liberties. Where does white play now?
Atari the two stones.
Atari two stones, here, it doesn't really matter. Okay, where does black play?
Connect over there for Atari.
That's Atari, free! Does the white want to die?
Capture. Nope.
Capture. Black's move, fix it.
Connect.
How does our group look?
Still no eyes.
No eyes yet, but...
It's got nine liberties.
I mean...
That's pretty good.
We can start... If we need to, we can find an item here. But yeah, look at those liberties, man. Aren't those liberties beautiful? How many liberties do we start with on these two stones?
Three.
How many liberties do we have now?
Nine.
Is it nine?
Nine.
Three, four, five. Yeah, nine. We went from three to nine. We tripled our liberty count. That's going to be really hard for white to kill. If white wants to kill us, white is going to have to work really hard at it. And not only that, if white tries to kill us a little bit, you know, too aggressively, these two stones are actually getting a lot weaker. If we even just get a little bit stronger, we can start playing moves like this. And remember all these points that look like white's? Because we're strong over here, white's gonna have to give them up. Otherwise, white will get swallowed. It's bad stuff. And if white plays here, you go there, and white's like, I don't wanna die. You go, that's great, white, I'm gonna eat this. Extends. Over here, might be able to play that first, sort of depending. White connects. We are just super duper alive here. Because we're strong here, right? We have a wall here. White doesn't have any choices. If white doesn't obey us, white's going to get eaten.
We're also kind of giving white a wall, too.
We are giving quite a while. We have to make sure we're strong over here first. Otherwise, our beautiful 9 liberty group will come under, like, super attack, right? Because white will have a, you know, 12 liberty wall right next to it. So we do have to be careful. That is right. We can't do that immediately. This is why your sense of timing in Go is really important. Like, not time to invade right now. We're not completely safe. But as soon as we get one or two more friends over here, sure. Okay.
Would it be better to extend it up?
Oh, this way?
Yeah.
It depends.
Depends.
This, I mean, this move gets you out faster, right?
Yeah.
If your friends are over here and you just need to make sure this is safe, this is going to get you closer to your friends.
Oh, because I was thinking like all around the board there, except for the lower left, you've got pretty much solid.
Here's what I don't like about this move, John. If I play here, white's going to go over here. I just gave white 3 points.
Oh, I could still go there even if you jumped up.
That's right. But now I'm further out. Right, this area is already settled. So playing more stones in a settled area doesn't do me a whole lot of good.
Yeah, okay, I think maybe I should do something
right now. Right, but if I go this way, well now I can do something, I can do other stuff. Yeah, I can go somewhere else.
Okay.
So I'm just saying, if you're gonna force white to make points, you know, and be really strong. You don't want your stones there. You want your stones playing somewhere else that's more useful.
Well, I was sort of thinking that one of the considerations as this situation developed was you're ending up with a lot of influence towards the center.
Yeah.
And the reason I was thinking maybe extend it up is to the extent that you have a longer wall, doesn't this give you more influence?
Yeah, but as soon as white sees your longer wall, you know, maybe white... doesn't want to take points. White says, oh, you're making a really big wall. Good for you.
Okay, that's the problem with having monkey.
Thank you. All right. I mean, and then if this is strong enough that, you know, black can't annoy this in any way, it was really hard, quite frankly, because if you attack this, white's going to come out and actually surround you on a large scale.
Uh-huh.
You know, maybe there's that move, but now your wall is really not useful because white got to play there first. So again, it depends on the entire board, okay? Is a short answer?
Yeah.
I guess that's a long answer. That's an answer. That's one answer. But right now, you have enough liberties here.
Yeah.
This, when you usually play this type of move, well, you need to gain an extra liberty.
Yeah.
Liberties aren't your problem.
Yeah, you're not short of liberties. Your one liberty, more or less, in itself doesn't work.
Yeah.
And I think what I've been underestimating is, like, for white just one. If it's good for white, it must be good for
that's
white.
Yeah, exactly, right? You know, if white has all the influence around my area, making my group gain one liberty isn't going to help me.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, isn't that a cool problem? So even though the net doesn't work, what is it set up for us? Tons of free stuff, right? And the other key move here, after you see this one, is this extension down. All right, white saves a stone. Why is this a good idea?
Two lifts is one move.
Hmm?
One move to throw that stone in, and white's gonna need two moves to take it.
That's right, it's a one for two relationship. We went from having one liberty to having three liberties with one move. And if white needs to kill this, that means it's going to take white two extra moves. You spent one move to get two extra moves. That's why it works.
Leverage.
A little bit of leverage, that's right. Cool problem? This is like, you know, I'll say this. When I was, you know, my first year of playing Go, I wasn't going to solve any of these. Like, this is just a practice skill. The more you practice seeing the shape moves, it's not really that hard of reading, per se. It's just finding the shape point. Like, my first year, couldn't do it. This year, I opened up the shape book after the first page, and I went, 5 seconds, I had them all solved. Right? This is something that you will get better at the more you do it, the more you practice these finding these shape points. And that's something that I guess, I'm not sure if I learned it from Janice Kim, Professional 3-Don, or not, but I was playing some Go with her, and she was insisting on drinking a lot and playing really quickly. And so the idea was, you know, the idea really wasn't for her, she wasn't playing serious Go, she wasn't trying to read everything, right? It was just like about identifying the shape points, right? And if you can find the shape point, you can take the 5 seconds to read out and tell if it works or not, you know, your Go skill is gonna get way faster because you're gonna get more efficient. You're gonna think about things in the game that you need to think more about, large strategy stuff. And those individual places you need to put your stones to get your stones stronger are going to come more naturally. You don't have to think about them as hard. So, anyway, just playing a game or doing exercises where you're not trying to read out every move. I know for, at your level, that's so important. You need to be able to read. Okay, doing life and death problems, reading out every move, super important. But there's a whole other style of practicing Go that no one ever really tells you about, and it's that, just finding the shape points. Right here, see, it's a mouth shape. Bam. Right, know that instinctively. The more you do that, the better luck you get. All right, ready for another one? Let's do this one. This one's not so much of a shape problem as a Tsuji problem that results in good shape. So we're trying to find a Tsuji that will give us good shape. Should we try this first? That's all you guys want to try, right? Alright, what goes there?
Mm-hmm. Doesn't look great except that you get to Hane on both sides of this group of two.
That's an important, that is an important, right? We're taking away liberties, right? So these two stones, two liberties, should be bad for white. But guess what?
White is fake.
Here, white doesn't even need to really, if white wants the corner, he needs to fix, but I mean, he's not in any trouble yet.
Yeah.
Alright, the best black can do is just get that. Right, and black will prevent white from getting any points here, but white is safe, right? Black can't cut, extend, black dies, extend, black dies. So and if white just wants those points, white will just play that right now and now there's nothing.
Yeah.
So did we get stronger? Did our opponent get weaker? Like I promised you with good shape moves? That's what I'm promising you if you learn the secrets of good shape. We gained 2 points in Sente. That's not good. Not good enough.
I think you can just, can you jump in and attach? The one on the left.
This one?
Yeah.
Ooh.
That's what I wanted to try.
Ooh. You're very strong with the force.
that's like the proper way to cut the knight's move, right? At the waist.
Often, yeah. I mean, of course, it depends on the ladders and the other everything else around it, but yeah. All right, so white cuts. Now what, pretty boy?
Cut.
Okay.
Just cut.
Yeah.
Jump right in.
Here.
Have to
cut.
Don't even read. Just cut.
Yeah. Have to cut. That's right. You should have read this out before you played this move out.
Yeah.
This move can backfire really quickly. All right. Think from the white player's perspective. What does white try?
Attack.
You could just capture that stone. Or you can take your free Atari and capture it.
I think he has to capture that stone.
Free Atari?
Does Black have some cleverer response than...
It's free Atari is actually bad. We're going to see why in a moment. Okay, so let's pretend... I'll show you why. Just trust me, this is bad.
Sure.
Okay. Let's have white play this. Because, quite frankly, that's the safest thing. White... Yeah. This three-stone group only has three... three liberties right now. Gain a fourth, but...
Yeah.
We may have a liberty problem if we play a little too cavalier. So, let's have to take that. All right, now what does black play?
Now black gets free Atari.
Yes. White has two options. What are they?
You gotta connect here.
Right, that's good shape for white, right? Farming, fill triangle, that's good.
Yeah.
Black, fix.
Fix.
How do you fix?
Well, if you've got a ladder, you should probably just connect, unless you're worried about a ladder breaker.
Yeah,
connect there.
That one.
That one, yeah.
This is the correct connection. Right? This is a bad move. And why is it a bad move? People who are here at the start of class?
Because white peeps, and also it looks...
White goes here.
Yeah.
So black says...
Actually, well, here, couldn't you extend down?
Here?
From the stone, and if white pushes in, you can just...
Atari.
Do something. Atari. Oh, that's Atari against you. Never mind. Don't do that.
I don't know. One of these.
Yeah.
I feel pretty good as white, actually.
Yeah.
How are these three stones doing?
They're scared.
They're scared.
Yeah.
Correct. Very scared.
Yeah, don't do that.
All right. So...
I guess you just have to connect.
So Tom has come around and said, now we have to connect. All right, white plays over here.
Probably connect.
Here you can actually get away with this.
Oh.
But white's not going to play this.
You're
going to connect? White connects?
White's
so...
Yeah,
got
shitty.
How are your farmlands?
It's bad harvest.
Bad harvest. Yeah, white got a free stone over here just for fun. Right? The stone is just fun, right? It was just completely free. Right? Nothing bad to white. And second, white got out on this side, and black has a whole bunch of stones that look kind of stupid. Black has made no less than 4 empty triangles in this region alone. Alright,
1, 2, 3, 4,
right, that's terrible. Okay, dumpling. Can't do it. So... You guys remember our discussion about tiger's mouths and the people who play them? We don't make them, okay? Now, if it's the only move, if you need all of your stones connected, if you have no way to defend against this, I mean no way, fine. Wait. But if you have any sort of way, you have a ladder, you've got friendly stones, you've got anything to fight this, you play here. Okay? No thinking. Pro move. Even if you have no friends, okay, you have nobody. You play here? Doesn't this kind of look like a mouth shape? Can you see a mouth forming here?
Can you...
White just played in the middle of your mouth shape. Play there.
Can you actually do that loose ladder?
No. Not cleanly.
Like it, because you've lost all your liberty.
That's fine. Look, I go here. Okay. White goes here.
Okay. I mean, if you just keep going, you'll end up with your three stones in Akari, so clearly you can't do that.
Why not?
Have you
over here? I gave up two stones, right?
Yeah.
Over here, I'm giving up three.
Okay, is this?
I'm saying in the most emergency of all situations, just give him three stones. Just capture him with the ladder.
The reason I'm skeptical is this looks worse to me than
White
you
owes
gave
me
up
a move over here.
The trumpet shape.
Yeah, but White owes me a move over here.
Okay.
Alright, so you have three more stones, so what? I play over here. Boom, mine.
I guess.
I'm not saying it's ideal, but I'm saying worst case scenario, White can cut and there's nothing you can do about it. You have no ladders, you have no friends, everybody hates you. You get this! Alright. That's worst case scenario. That's not the scenario in almost like 95% of situations. Okay, White just can't go cutting everywhere. It's a bad idea. But here's the coolest thing about this, you guys might not have realized. Notice Black ended in Goten. That's sad, right? Tari, and then had to come back and fix. If White Tanukis, Black gets to play this for free. We now have more Sente moves against the corner.
Yes.
Now this corner is in trouble, if White doesn't respond. So if White just fixes...
Ooh.
Check out my wall, man.
Black stone back on position there.
Hmm?
The stone closest to you.
Yeah, right. Oh, these, yeah, sorry.
How do we attack if White doesn't fix?
Well, you can start with that. Oh, actually, you know what? I think I set up the problem wrong. Sorry. Let's pretend that's there.
That looks better.
No, you know why? Because we took down this problem in the first.
Yeah.
I set it up right, and then I tried to put it back, and I failed. Sorry. That's important. All right. Coolest part. Ready? There, you play there. Yeah, the other way doesn't kill White.
Okay.
But here, White has a problem. White's like, aha, I'm going to eat you. You say... Oh, really? What's his... Oh, okay. And I go, you have one eye. Oh. All right, sorry. Good job, David.
So this is Gotei for Black, but with a Sente follow.
With a Sente follow to seal winning. With a pretty awesome walls. I mean, you get two walls like this, very hard for White to do anything on this part of the board. Cool. All right, so what was the Tsuji that made all this beautifulness happen?
Cut the boys.
Yeah, cutting right across, right, and noticing that these three stones only have three liberties. That's why I was like, how do they gain an extra liberty? You first looked at it, and you guys all said three, and I went, no, White can get four. All right, don't worry about it. Anyway, right, now White really only has three liberties, right? So there's no place to get more liberties. Cool. Okay, I addressed a couple of issues. Take a look at this one. This is one I would describe as just being fancy. I wouldn't say this is like one of your must-know shapes, and in fact, it's actually gonna violate some of the other principles we've taught you. But it's just being really creative with your sense of shape. That's what we're looking for here. What's Black's problem?
There's a push and cut.
At any point, well, I can say, hey, and you go, hey. And White says, oh, I eat. And Black goes, oh, that's kind of sad. And White says, no, I still eat you. And Black's like, oh, I still need to fix. And Black's like, oh. White got free food, essentially, anytime. What do you want to try?
We could
make the bamboo joint, right? So that's good shape.
It doesn't really do anything to White.
That's right. It does nothing to White. Nothing.
It they start to keep them come around.
How about descending?
So descending.
So
you're saying, hey, we're gonna threaten white.
If white descends with you, you still have a push and cut problem, but I mean, at least then that's better than just making.
White plays this.
Oh, okay. Just try the block.
Why? I'm not sure if we need to go with the stone first or not. Let's,
work out. Can't do that.
Yeah, wait here.
Okay.
We capture.
And, yeah, so white can get a forcing move.
That doesn't seem bad.
Just capture
one. I think the one, you know.
Sentai. White.
Yeah, that's still better than making the bamboo joint, I think.
Better than making the bamboo joint. It's better. But not good enough.
Oh, how about diagonal backwards this way? Because then the push and cut doesn't work.
Like
and,
this?
Yeah.
There we go.
And white can't honey at the top.
That's the creative shape I'm looking for.
So if white pushes out, you block it.
Yep.
I
think white can still carry
on top.
That's great. I love white. If white does this,
yeah,
it's beautiful.
Yeah,
my wall's solid, just as solid as before.
Yeah,
white is. But now there's.
White doesn't have to.
Doesn't have to yet. But now black's gonna get extra endgame. Right later on, black can play all this ascent take.
Yeah.
All right, white has to take. Black comes back. If white doesn't fix, black's gonna get even more. Right. So instead of giving white free stuff, we went to giving black free stuff. Pretty significant. And actually, you know what? That original variation, I kind of lied to you a little bit. If black doesn't fix right now, white's actually probably gonna play something a little more severe like this.
Yeah.
Now you're thinking, well, I have to fix with I think I was off. Now I have to fix the bamboo joint. But then white comes over here and lives over here in the middle of your wall. Influence.
So if your wall is keeping two white forces from.
Yeah, but if this white is safe and this white is safe,
your wall does
nothing.
Keeps them from running into each other.
Yeah, but if your opponent makes two life groups, you want them to run into each other. Usually. Right here, black does anything else. Even that, no more, that doesn't work anymore, right? White just says, oh, it's fun time. I didn't realize. Eats it all. So, we have to break a couple of the things we just learned. Right? In order to find a move like this, it's a really nice move, though. Right? If white doesn't respond, white goes here, and white says, oh no, I'm gonna die. And then we go here. White says, oh no, I'm gonna die. We seal this off, we took away a bunch of white points, we got more points for ourselves, all in Sente. So it's again, it's a Gotei-ish move with a bunch of Sente follow-ups. Very similar to this. Cool shape. This one, you guys are gonna have a problem with.
Bottom left.
No, that's not there yet.
Seems like that's such a defect that maybe that's the first priority.
That's right here?
Yeah.
That is such a defect, John, that I agree with you wholeheartedly. That is the shape we need to fix.
So there's two, three ways happening
there?
John says there are three ways. We need to pick one of the three ways.
Four,
John, what are the three ways?
Four. Well, one is just connect.
Connect. Yeah, I can. Okay. What else you got?
Two tiger's mouths
and one.
And what's the problem with this tiger's mouth?
Well, white has a stone right there for keeping.
White goes here.
Yeah.
Free move for white. Right. You might as well have just connected.
What about
this one? This tiger's mouth?
Same thing.
White gets a free move there. We don't make tiger's mouths, okay? Only when you absolutely need to for some reason, okay? This is not a good shape. And if your opponent does it all over the place, just go book, book, book. You know, just be that really annoying sibling. Just pokes your other sibling in the whole car ride. Just poke, 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 right?
How's about this one? The diagonal.
What if you went up from there, that one?
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you guys think?
I'm not sure it's white much better, but white still can't cut directly.
This one is nice.
No, you can't cut it in.
This one's very nice.
Yeah. If he tries to cut it, you just can't.
Yeah, you just run him around, so.
Yeah, no cut, right? Just bloop, die. If white tries to cut this way.
You can actually.
Hey, you connect for free, and white stone looks stupid. Right? Because now you have two stones surrounding him, right? White's already in trouble. Unlike this one, we just peep. Right? And black just goes here. Look, liberties, friends, everything. But over here, if we do this, now this stone will get eaten. Anything else white can do here?
White.
Anything else for white to do to this shape to mess with it?
Well, we could look at the other side of it.
Not really.
What if white does this?
Oh, well, that's good. He now can cut directly, it looks like.
Can.
So, the question, it seems like, is does black have a response to this that's like an okay move in terms of doing something and makes the cut not work again?
That's a good way to think about it.
How about,
attach?
Diagonal?
Attach diagonal?
Yeah.
Diagonal.
Yeah. Like that, maybe?
It works. It's not great shape, quite frankly.
Yeah.
Depending on the overall situation.
But this
I might also be more inclined to do something like this. Mm. And you say, well, what about the cut? And I say, who cares about the cut? Because I'm just going to run you this way.
If you're running the other way?
Possibly, but it's really tough. Whoops. We gave white 4 more points. That's what we gave up. But now what?
What about this cut now at once?
Black not in trouble?
I have a stone, right? Whenever white cuts this, I go, okay, here. Pick one. Where are these three stones? I'm so much stronger over here now. Right? And not only that, remember these white points who we almost destroyed earlier? Definitely gonna get them now. Right? If we have a wall here and a wall there. I'm very happy to give white 4 points to basically almost kill this stone, get out underneath over here, get a nice big strong wall. If all my stones are strong, I'm very happy about giving up 4 points. I know all you guys are like, but there's a bamboo joint, you should keep.
Well, then black can just take
it. I'm happy just filling
okay.
Here. It's still really hard for white to do anything. Because white has to fix this somehow. But if you fix this, maybe play over here, threatening this. I'm thinking I'm gonna kill all this, is what I'm thinking about right now. It's very hard for white to, you know, survive okay over here, especially if there's a big black wall over here. Survive here and save this. It's very busy. So here's the thing. When you have a situation like this, you just have to be really flexible. Yeah, there are times you just want to connect, okay? But it doesn't help you make eye shapes, it doesn't really help you attack white. This is almost like luring white into a trap. Right? Saying, hey white, you know, maybe you can get those, maybe. You play some moves over here. Make me stronger over here, and then make me stronger over here. Maybe you can get that. That's exactly what you want. That's what you want to say to your opponent, right? You can take those if you want them. I'm not scared of that because I will get something better. Right? That's a great way to play Go. This move is super cool, right? Helps you get out. Helps make eye shape if you need it. Connects all your stones. Very cool.
So that response on the second line, how did that help you do what you wanted to
do? If I'm going to give up these, that means white can cut me off.
Right.
So if I get cut off, I want to make sure these stones are strong. So if I get this stone, if I get this stone here,
it makes an easy eye.
Yeah, I'm out, and I don't have to think about it too hard. It might not be the best move, David, but I kind of want white to kill those, right? So I'm just preparing to take all of this. Because, quite frankly, this move for white is really powerful.
Yeah.
Right? You have to figure out, usually defend it like this if these stones are in sort of trouble. But then this move gets powerful too, right? Because now we're going to be threatening that cut if we play like this. I'm trying to avoid this whole mischief area. Right? So, that's all.
Actually, if you put it back, that starts to be really scary for black.
It is scary for black.
Yeah.
That's why I'm saying that's why I played here.
Yeah. If white cuts.
If white cuts, I'm definitely going this way, right? Like, no question.
Yeah, because essentially I think you have to give up one side or the other.
Yeah, but these are not big.
Yeah.
I bet if I give these two up and I get a wall here, a bigger, better wall than two stones?
You'd be a mistake to go the other way because you just lose the other stone.
Yeah, then that's problematic.
That's a problem. Okay.
Okay, cool. I'm going to flip it out. We'll see if you guys are shape masters.
These
four more problems.
Harder by intention?
They're earlier in the book, so they should be easier. I think one of them is definitely easier. I think two of them are kind of easier, and the last one's not really. Let's try it. I want to start with this one. Black to play. Who thinks we should save our stone?
Seems,
I think there are best things you can do.
Seems conscripted.
It's really dangerous, too.
Yeah.
I know, and I didn't put up another stone over here because it affects this corner, but I probably should have. Again, I was trying to arrange them so I could put all have space for all four problems. But if white's just a little bit stronger over here, I can pretty easily just come out and threaten both this and this.
How about 14-5?
14-5 there. White plays here.
Atari. Bubble. Atari. You do have two cutting coins again. Yeah, I mean, I guess you fix one side and fight, but okay, that's probably the answer.
Not the answer. Definitely not the answer.
White keeps playing 13-5, so just play 13-5.
Yes. This is the move white needs to split you, right? You are forcing white to play 13-5 in all these. Alright, where does white play?
Capture,
good. Sure, where's black play?
Double Atari.
Double Atari, hey, alright.
Well, sort of.
So in. Black?
Well, you can play out a little to fix the cut.
How do we fix it?
15-6.
Good. Mouth.
Yeah.
Good.
Or
nice.
I mean, I guess if white actually has those three stones there, there might actually be value in connecting to your one and trying to threaten that. Although, well, white's strong. Nah.
No.
Eh.
Yeah, white's strong. Have to fix the cut. Make a mouth shape, right? We're one stone away from a completed mouth. Very nice. Very nice. Hard for white to attack this now. And you're right. Later on, you go, hey, white, I get your points. White says, no, I don't get more points. And maybe if you have more stone, a stone over here, maybe you can take some points over here. Or it's like, no, don't make my points. And you're like, I want some stone over here. White's like, no, don't make my points. And over here, don't take my points. All right, eventually.
So you're playing against the Pillsbury Doughboy.
That's right.
You're saying.
There's that game reduction over here.
Woohoo, these are my points.
That's right. Right, there's a lot of defects actually later on. So, but just fix. Stay strong, right? Wasn't that nice? We went from this pile of garbage that was in trouble to actually something with decent shape, right? Pretty strong stones. It wasn't that hard. Now, if we connect, where are we gonna get our shape black? You know, maybe we can get two eyes, right? Play over here and play over here. This group can be saved. But what's gonna happen in the meantime to these two? Yeah, train wreck. All right, this one. Black to play.
With the black still in it.
Yeah, and actually, really, these shouldn't be here. This is movies, I think, but it won't matter too much. Really, again, there's a key shape point in this shape that you guys should just identify. It's a point that both players really, really want. Really badly. And unless you know it, it's actually hard, surprisingly hard point to see. Because, it kind of goes against what I've been teaching you.
Seems to be, it would be critical, something that you'd want to play on, and I'd say like seven or something, or eight?
Four, five, six, seven.
Just coming out there, up one, yeah. I'd say, are we playing black to play or what?
Oh, it's black to play. Sorry, wrong color. Yeah. It's important for both players, though.
Yeah.
Either one will take it.
That seems to be a point of interest to both, so that's one candidate.
Yeah.
And the other one would be like either 2-3 or 3-3. Yeah.
Does white have a super clever response to 3-3? Because 3-3 actually looks okay to me if you're threatening to connect under and possibly to make a
favor.
My boy's here. Yeah, that's going to be a little stupid.
Well, I said 3-3, like 4-3.
Oh, sorry. I think white still plays there.
Okay.
Actually, no. White will cut you first. Yeah, white will cut you first. Now what?
Oh, never. I was about to say you connect underneath, but that doesn't
black
work.
Black does have this really fancy move. You got that move?
Oh, that's neat. Yeah. To try to connect both directions.
Yeah. But it's not good here.
Yeah, okay.
This place is going to get more in trouble in three places instead of two.
So just play the straightforward one?
This is the move. Let's see why this is so important. Let's say black does something over here like this, trying to make this live. White plays here.
And then you force kind
of... It's actually way more difficult for these three stones to make two eyes. Like, surprisingly more difficult. Usually, you guys have been here a while, been going to this class for a while, we used to have this saying, you go 1, 2, 3, jump. You remember this? Like if you're pushing, jump! Right, after if you push three times, jump. How many times did black push before jumping?
Two.
Twice.
Oops.
If we have one more push, probably okay. But going 1, 2, jump. Big defect. How does black make two eyes here?
On the third one.
Those two white stones down there are actually there, I assume?
Yeah.
If we connect here?
Yeah.
I think white will be satisfied to go there.
And then on the fourth,
you could kind of slide.
Welcome, come on in.
Oh, thank you.
Slide?
Sure.
I was thinking going in.
You can try it.
Yeah, it seems like you either got a high slide and a slide,
so you get two more space. There's no cut there.
Whatever you do, this is going to block and seal you in, right?
Yeah.
You're going to, if you live, you should live, but it's going to be super sad. White's going to get sensei. White's going to be super strong and solid on the outside.
4-8.
4-8 up here?
No.
Oh, this
four,
one?
No, I'm sorry, 9.
9, 4-9.
Yeah. Okay, what's white do there?
What's the play there?
His favorite shape.
Okay, then do 4-8.
Dynamite. White's so happy. So happy.
Now black's dead. There's only a reason to do that if you're going to fight,
right? Black has that one. It
doesn't seem like it. It's kind of
probably this first.
Yeah.
And white's got enough liberties that he doesn't have to ladder you. He can just net you because you're like...
And then we need one more move over here. Black's alive. But
white's gonna come down.
You're gonna pay for it. White's super strong. Black made about 7 points. But what is white going to get? Yeah, I mean, this is going to be super hard to make live. So.
And that's all because he went 1-2 jump instead of 1-2-3 jump?
Basically, yeah. I mean, it's, even if you go 1-2-3 jump, if white has enough stones, it'll be still difficult for black to live.
Yeah.
But, yeah, 1-2 jump is surprisingly weaker, especially, it's not just because 1-2 jump, but it's also because we had the 1-2 jump, and we don't have this point. This point is so key. All right, once we have this point, it gets way more difficult for white to attack us. Because not only, white can't even really seal us in cleanly. Right? White can't just con and just say, hey, you're stuck in there. No, we get out.
You're very difficult.
Sometimes, you need it. Maybe I can try this. But I'm not even sure that's Sente. Now black can come over here and live or do something else, you know? And actually, quite frankly, you know, white has to play a move over there, probably that one. There's a cut here, right, that black might be able to exploit and take advantage of later, right? White's shape isn't very strong. So this key point is really key for both players, right? It makes this group, who has no eyes currently, right, black can take them away. Gives them a lot more liberties, puts a lot of pressure on here, makes white super strong. And does basically all the same stuff for black. So give black much better eye potential. So, key point. Again, this is a type of point you just recognize. Right? It's hard, it can be a very difficult point to read out because a lot of the variations are complex, but you know, 1-2 jump, there is a defect in here somewhere. It's up to you to just find it. Alright, let's look at this one. This one's pretty cool.
Really want to connect.
How do you connect?
The Hane stone.
Hane, David says, we connect through the Hane. And then we laugh at him. Why? What does white do?
Cut.
Which one?
Cross cut the Hane?
Yeah, I think we can do either. They're both cut something. All right, how does black survive this?
You can't connect, right? You'll lose the liberty race at the bottom.
So you connect here.
Yeah, you gotta do it.
Yeah.
Three
yeah.
liberties, four liberties. White wins.
So you have to let white cut both sides. You have to Atari and then.
Is there something bigger you can do than save those four?
Did you connect, David?
No.
Okay. But we have to check it. We have to try, right? You knew what we had to do. We have this group that's kind of struggling down here. We have this one stone over here. We have to figure out a way to make them all work together.
This is one of these. Yeah.
Eric has an idea.
I think I've seen something like this before, and I haven't written this out. But on the second line instead.
You are which point on the second line?
Where we played on the third line. Don't play on the third line. Play on the second.
There you go. This is the move. Now, we have to read it out.
Yes.
Because what happens when white plays here?
Oh, well, we have to
You
cut.
Still can't.
No.
No.
Can't cut.
You still can't cut because you have the exact same problem.
Remember, we just did this.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I have to find better.
Just Hane underneath.
Hane, where's white going to go now?
He doesn't.
White go there?
Back. He dies.
Ta-da, white dies. So, white goes here?
Yeah, and then...
Oh, ta-da, you're connected.
Whoa.
Like, total brain spasm, right? Just like, that worked? Here, let's try another way. What if white just pushes?
Even better?
So...
Can you extend from the bottom?
You do
that. Here?
Does that work?
No. No, but we can...
Yeah,
me too.
So, but
I beat Matt.
So you have to, if you pull back at the bottom.
This is the move.
Yeah, because at least.
White the Saints? Same shape, right? Mm. White can push, you connect. This shape is pretty magical. This is not a shape you try to play, okay? I want to point out the keystones in this shape. You see this stupid looking triangle? This is usually a bad shape. Unless you're near the edge of the board, then it's magical. Okay? But we have a knight's jump to a knight's jump to a big knight's jump, right? Big triangle, distorted triangle. Middle of the board, it's terrible. Don't do it, ever, right? But near the edge of the board, sorry, that's there, right? Make some real magic happen. Okay? But did you see, like pretend the shape was in the middle of the board? You see all of these cuts? Right? Middle of the board, you are screwed, right? Why is this just cut and win the game? No problem. But because you're near the edge of the board, none of these cuts work. So, it's a cool shape, not a good shape, you know, typically speaking, but near the edge of the board, it's pretty cool. Cool? One more. Black to play. I think this is the easiest one of all. It's all of you guys should be bam, the mouth stop.
I'm not going to put black loops in on the board here.
What? How?
Oh, 30, I mean, he's out.
How does Mike kill this?
No, I'm talking about the last problem.
Oh, down here?
Yeah.
All right, John, gotta kill it. You're white. Go.
White on the 2-2 point. And then white, let me see, on the bottom line. No. White on the 2-2 point. I get black jumps in there. I get white comes in on the bottom line there, right there, right? And let's see. Okay, white down, 2-1, yeah, okay, and, okay, maybe he gets it.
Mike actually doesn't have to play there, right?
No, I do have to respond, but I can respond over here or over here, I actually have a choice.
Black's got to respond.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm pretty safe.
Okay, so if white made that connection underneath, not going to get anywhere. Because it looks,
I know it looks like it'd be cut.
Yeah,
damn.
Okay.
It's magic.
Okay, I got it now.
All right. This one. Let's go back to this one. Final one.
Close the mouth.
Mouth shape, right? Key point. You guys all recognize. Mouth. There's a mouth being formed. Where does black have to play if black wants to attack? There.
Right.
Now, it actually gets more interesting of a problem if you think about it this from white's perspective.
What did you call that position?
This is the mouth shape?
Yeah.
Mouth.
Key point.
So now white's being cut.
Yeah,
so white needs to connect.
Yeah. Here? David likes empty triangles.
Could you cut at the waist like that one other problem?
I mean, black does have an elephant's eye.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So white might be able to do something.
Black has two good options here.
Rough.
Let's just play there. I mean, it depends which side of the board is bigger.
Yeah.
But basically, black will cut off and make one side of the board his.
Okay.
If we try this prematurely, I think it's a bad idea. Because...
I mean, all you can really do is crudely push through.
I mean, best case scenario, black cuts here. And we'll play here.
Yep.
This doesn't really feel good for white. We don't actually have two eyes yet. So... I think the best response for white is actually here. That's not there yet.
There, and then get out that way.
Yeah, and try to run to friends, basically. But black is put here now. And white's like, oh, shit. Right. Black can just keep white really low, maybe even cut, again, it depends what's over here. But either way, black's just gonna own this, black's safe down here, white has nothing, white's just running. So, if you've learned anything from today, your opponent does this. Where's the key point? You just go smack! Down! Pretend he's a cat, take a little spray bottle. Backhanding. Okay, very least, do this. Make some suffer every time. Okay? How is that? You feel the power of making good shapes, seeing key points. And the more shapes you play, quite frankly, it'll speed up your role playing too. Because you're gonna start reading a lot, or needing to read a lot less moves. Right? You'll focus on the key points, the shapes, see what works. And once in a while, you'll find none of the key shape points work. Then you can start reading the non-shape points. Maybe find the one that shouldn't work but totally does, and then it's awesome and it's glorious. But try to look at the key points first. Okay? All right, you guys want to play some Go for about a little over half an hour, I guess? Yep. Play a quick game in.